Ukrainian officials said that their troops have managed to push back Russian forces from the northern city of Kharkiv. You can see a yellow and blue flag flying once again in a town outside Kharkiv, recaptured by Ukrainian forces. On the side of the road, abandoned and burned out Russian military vehicles. And drone footage shows Ukrainian troops targeting a Russian T-90 tank in Kharkiv, but more fighting might be coming. Ukraine says Putin is diverting troops north into the region. Want to bring in retired U.S. Army Major Mike Lyons. Major, thanks so much for being with us. Can you show us what you think is happening in the Kharkiv region, the success the Ukrainians have had, and now the countermeasures being taken by the Russians?
Sure, John. So if you go to Kharkiv here, you see what's taking place here. The yellow on the map here shows the advances of the Ukraine military as they've gotten up every day to kill and capture and destroy Russian equipment. And what's happened is now, put a circle around it. It's now inoculated against any kind of artillery fire. So the city is somewhat safe right now. But these yellow regions here now actually threaten Belgorod if they want to do artillery. But now let's come and face east here. This is the next objective here, I believe, for the Ukraine military, as Russian forces are going to be forced now to leave Izium, places in the south in the Donbass region, to come and reinforce this town, Kupiansk, which is the major logistical supply point for where the Russians are getting logistics and communications coming in. The fact that they have to withdraw from that main fight in the Donbass, in this region here, they're having some success here. Krematorsk, we know that's their primary objective. But the fact that they've got to take troops offline to this area to bring them back here, tremendous failure from the military's perspective.
So the Ukrainians are having enough success around Kharkiv that it, in a way, is hampering the rest of the Russian efforts in Donbass. They're having to move troops?
Yeah, absolutely. What's happened is the 20 or so battalion tactical groups that Russia deployed into the region after failing in Kyiv have been grinded up. They've been virtually spit out, and they've had to then move, let's say, the 40 or 50 that have been in the region so far and replace them. The thing is, this area is just too big. It's just too big an area for 40 or 50 battalion tactical groups to try to do anything offensively, okay? So again, Russia gets up every day. Their primary mission is to take lands, and they're failing miserably at it. Now, they still have tremendous capability to do that. Ukraine military gets up every day with one mission: kill and destroy Russian equipment, kill and capture Russian soldiers. The bottom line is Russia doesn't have enough to keep them on the offensive, and it's forced them, again, to do things like this: come back to places like Kupiansk to make sure that they have the logistical supply chain that they need.
Do they have enough to keep it a stalemate, though, Major? That's one of the things we've been hearing the last few days. If Russia wants to stay where it is right now, what happens?
Well, the equipment pouring in from the West is going to provide the Ukraine military, the artillery in particular, that's going to give them an advantage. And what I mean by that is the standoff. So if you put like a zone that exists here, we can shoot fire, the Ukraine military can shoot into a deeper spot than the Russians can fire back at Ukraine in terms of artillery. So that's the advantage that Western artillery is going to bring to this fight. And it's pouring in its self-propelled howitzers and also the towed howitzers, the ones coming in on trucks. We're seeing tremendously accurate and precise artillery fires in this region as part of this battle. They can hold off if the Russians don't move, the Russians don't learn, they don't maneuver, they don't kind of break out, and the Ukraine military can get that equipment to the spot.
Retired U.S. Army Major Mike Lyons, I really appreciate it. That was an education. Thank you, sir.
Thanks.